I'm Sarah Chisnell, staff scientist here in the Discovery Theater on the third floor at Science North. This year, we're celebrating National Fire Prevention Week, which is October 4th through the 9th, 2010. And we've teamed up with Sudbury Fire Services to bring you a live presentation all about fire and the ways of preventing it. So here in the Discovery Theater, we do many great experiments. Most of them involve fire. Fire can be very dangerous, but can also be very exciting. A fire needs three main ingredients to happen, which all fit quite nicely into what's known as the fire triangle. We need fuel, heat, and oxygen. Our atmosphere contains about 21% oxygen, so it's just enough to have a great fire. So all we need next is a source of fuel, which we have our paper here, and some heat from our lighter. So when this happens, we get a really nice fire. Now in order to put it out, we just need to remove the oxygen. So we'll put this bell jar over top, we're gonna take all the oxygen away, and our fire will go out. We burned some paper. Paper isn't typically what we use to burn in our homes or to heat with our homes. What we use is called a hydrocarbon. The most common type of hydrocarbon that we use is called methane, or natural gas, you might know that as. Methane has one carbon atom surrounded by hydrogen, so it's very light. Now, methane bubbles, as you can see here, will float nicely up into the air. When they rise and they hit the flame, we get a great big fireball. So when your methane is in your house, if you have a methane gas leak, it will float up. Hopefully it won't encounter any kind of ignition source on its way up, unlike it does right here. Another common type of hydrocarbon that we burn around our house, not much in our house, but around, is called propane. Propane has three carbon atoms, whereas methane only had one, so it's much, much heavier than methane. Propane has a molecular weight of 44.1 grams per mole. As I mentioned before, air is about 29, so when propane comes in contact with air, it'll typically sink and move that air out of the way. When propane sinks, if it hits an ignition source, just like now, you can see we get a great big flame that trails all the way up. So it wouldn't be very great to use propane inside the house, where it could potentially leak down to the basement and be ignited from your furnace or your hot water tank. We just seen when the propane flows down the trough, as soon as it hits that ignition source, we get a nice fire. Carbon dioxide behaves in very much the same manner. It'll flow down the trough, has about the same molecular weight as propane, but instead it's used as a fire extinguisher because it flows down the trough, displacing the oxygen, and it's not flammable, so nothing can catch on fire while that's around. As mentioned previously, we've teamed up with Sudbury Fire Services to bring you National Fire Prevention Week. And as such, here's Mitch Terrio, a local fire prevention officer, to tell you more about that.
So as you know, we're here to talk about Fire Prevention Week and fire safety. The main goal is to prevent fires, but in case a fire actually does ever happen, one of the best ways to put it out and the most effective ways, especially in your home, is to use a fire extinguisher, something like we have here today. This is a ABC extinguisher, it's dry chemical, and pretty much this is what you see most common extinguisher throughout businesses and in people's homes. So we're gonna talk about how to use it, really quick and effective tool to use. We're gonna pull the pin. We use the PASS acronym, so it's pull the pin. It always has a little safety tab on it, so it's not hard to break. You just twist it, and it snaps. This little tab snaps right off. So we pull the pin. We're gonna aim it at the base of the fire, and then we're gonna squeeze the trigger. This top handle here, we're gonna squeeze this down and sweep side to side to cover the entire fire area.
So that was just a taste of what you'll be able to see here in the Discovery Theater during National Fire Prevention Week, October 4th through the 9th, 2010. So come on down to Science North and come see this great show all about fire and fire prevention.